All right, guys, very special package just came in. They just released here in Seattle at a couple stores locally. The Jumpman Jacks, size 9.5. I want to do an unboxing for you guys.
My size.
Just to show you how crazy this shoe really is. Just feel how heavy duty that is. You know, just the casing.
This reminds me of the CPFM.
Quality, right?
Yep, mm-hmm.
Honestly, guys, this might be shoe of the year at the moment. I know we're still pretty early into the year, but from what I saw, the packaging, the numbers released, only 100,000 pairs, so it is extremely limited.
There you go. All right. Drum roll.
Damn. Wow. Honestly, I'm in love with this shoe. Hype aside, I did have a lot of love for the shoe when they first showed the pictures. It kind of reminds me of the Nike Air Yeezy 2 midsole.
It reminds me of the reverse Travis Low.
The reverse Mocha?
The reverse Mocha,
definitely, yeah. Has reverse Mocha vibes. Comes with extra laces.
Three extra laces.
Oh, wow. Signature smiley on the back. Mm-hmm. I mean,
the strap reminds me of the KD7.
Is this shoe of the year?
Man, I think it's too early.
Honestly, really dope shoe. Packaging is A1. Shout out, mm-hmm, to Jumpman, Jordan Brand. We're going a little bit above and beyond their everyday release as normal.
Maybe a little cream hit.
Cream vibes. Yeah. Let me know what you guys think about this shoe, and if you guys hit on a pair that dropped this morning, Jumpman Jacks,
14
they are
pairs.
Up. It's
minimum.
Up.
All right, guys, so a 2-hour flight all the way down to the OC. We're here to work on fall collection for RLC. Should we do a little fit check?
Fit check.
Fit check, go ahead, go ahead, John, go ahead.
Drip check. Oh, me? You know, just a little stink t-shirt from Heavyweights. You guys know that release we just dropped, baby. You guys don't know about the Wolfpack stink. Then, you know, I got the big Spinellis on. I'm not even gonna call Spinelli no more. I'm just call me Big Spit.
Hey, I'm not gonna lie, Johnny, those are growing on me. The more you wear them, the more I mess with them.
So I'm like mold, baby, I spread. You know what I mean? But yeah, we got the RLC. These aren't even coming, huh? They've been asking about these in the
Let
comments.
Us know, do you guys want these to come out? We scrapped them. We didn't actually put them into production, but.
So I got a one of one.
If you guys want them, let
Fire.
Us know. Let us
you guys got to check out the details, man. Crazy. Then we got the OG Heavyweights hat, cut off shorts, and just some.
Cash.
Nice.
What you got on, Rich?
I got the, what you guys call the Rick, the Vans. I got the Vans on. I got the Yeezy sweats right here. I don't know what season. And then I also got the Kith jacket right here. Super light. You gotta feel this material. I was freezing on the plane.
Wow.
I was freezing on the plane. Decided to let my hair down today.
Hey,
let my hair down today.
It's there. The process
I'm
is
still,
done.
I'm still learning how to style it and everything.
Yeah, I'm letting mine down today too.
Damn, fresh. All right.
I got some sunflower seeds that Johnny just gave me, and these are weird.
Yo, really?
You don't like them?
Bro, they're like sweet.
Yeah, it's like sweet, but then it has that Capricorn finish.
When I taste sunflower seeds, I'm not thinking
look,
sweet.
Look. The palate of a big man is just a little bit different. We have a little more complexity to our palate.
All right. Man, shoot. We got the sold out 3.0 cargoes from RLC. The sold out knitted one. I'm just wearing sold out everything, man. So we going to re-up the website. Brand new collection coming out soon.
That's why we're here.
This is like my favorite hoodie you guys came out with.
The perfect
insane.
Between just casual, just, you know, perfect hoodie. And then we got the classic Saint Laurent sneakers right here. These are my go-tos right here.
We're being a little loud right now. We're in the Uber pickup. Everybody's looking. So,
sorry, guys.
What was it back in town?
Johnny, whoa. Would you rock these?
Is this a real question?
Yes.
You know I'm rocking the shit out of these, bro.
I think we sampled those.
No way.
That's our sample.
Yeah.
Is it?
I'm taking this with me.
Look at the tag.
I'm taking this with me.
Oh, there's no RLC tag. We are the ones that made these.
Yo, these are wild.
We call these
This is like teddy bear. This is like teddy bear vibe, dog.
Oh, what y'all think? Those do have the RLC tag on the back.
Yeah. Oh, this one, dude.
Yeah. You wasn't lying.
These are
innovative.
These are wild. I see their creative process. You gotta go all the way out and then tone it down. Yeah. Rocking around Vegas with some bear pants on, boy. Bear shorts, not even pants. Yeah, I already got that. As you know, at the Leverage, we're here. The boys are doing work. We gotta take a little break to do a little 3-point contest with your very own. Coming in at Sticks and Bones, Tan Tang, first on the list. What does winner get? What are y'all playing for?
A band.
What?
Whoa, my man feeling confident.
A band? All right.
We go first.
You go first. Go on.
All right. No. This is for real, though. This is for a band.
That's not 10.
A band. Band, though.
Max.
Trying to act like he didn't miss just 10 before this.
Oh my god!
Oh, he pulled a Will Smith on me. The
good old. I pulled the Ryan Garcia on you, boy.
He's feeling the pressure, I already know.
Man, on the line, right?
7 for 9! 7 for 9!
For a band, I gotta take off the jacket, you know?
Nervous?
Nervous? Never nervous. A little bit, though.
Rich,
put a little pressure on you?
Come on Wednesday to hoop with us?
Yeah.
Or if you guys
don't play. We haven't been in a while, so.
G-Money,
bring
us up to the block, man.
Yeah, take some shots. Hey, what up, y'all? You know what I'm saying?
Big OG right here.
I got the fam in the house right now. You know what I'm saying?
Best storyteller I know, man. You want a couple stories, man? You ask this man.
We'll talk about that later. You know what I'm saying?
Hey. Let
me know.
Let
me know you're ready.
There you go.
Whoa.
That's 1 for 1?
That's 1 for 1. Go ahead. 1 for 2. 1 for 2 for 3. So, tell me how it feels to take a loss right now. What's going on? What's going on in your mind?
He definitely pulled a Fresh Prince on me where you act like you're
weak. Richie's like, oh, he's off today. I got this.
He's off today. And then he put a band on and starts going ham.
That's the weasel. How's it feel to win? One extra band.
Hey, it was for a bando, you know? Gotta be mando. Mando for bando.
Look at that. You saw it here first, the leverage.
All right, guys, just landed. Man, gonna meet up with Hung Bros. Let's get to the hotel and start.
Viva!
That road was super long from LA to here. It felt like 2 hours.
Really? I closed my eyes and I woke up and we were here. It was amazing. I love it.
You were reading a book. You just had a book.
You know, the intention was to read, but I gotta rest up.
This guy's been carrying a book this whole trip. Ain't reading one page.
No, don't see. That's not the problem. Everybody always watch what I'm doing. What y'all watch me for?
He read the title.
Right. It's lit. On arrival, he was singing the song when you guys came in. It was perfect. It was a perfect entry.
All right, you guys obviously know David and Andrew, the Funk Bros, came out with their own sauce, Shmala chili oil. It's a nice little blend between the Italian style and a little bit of Szechuan. So we're gonna try it today, what we got going on.
Wow, Johnny, you're selling it so well.
Indeed, let's see, baby. I'm gonna get a nice amount on there.
Ooh, you got a lot on there.
It's crazy because I've tried it on so many different things and it works with so many different things.
Listen, guys, Asian fusion food, it makes perfect sense because Smala is half Sicilian, half Sichuan.
Chinese flavors with Italian sensibilities.
I'm putting on everything we tried.
On the oyster?
Not a lot.
You know how they do Tabasco and oysters, right? Why not this, you know? Voila! Smala!
What's going on right now?
Oh,
we're
man.
We're swagging our way.
We're just getting ready for the club, you know.
Okay, man, when you don't got scissors, you just use the clippers.
Yo, I've never seen someone use the Andes T-liners to trim.
Hey, we call that
But you should, because this sharp is this sharp
is hair. We call that a cut and sewn edge up.
Like more than going ham on them threads.
I'm about to get it gritty. See me do my dance, make me do the gritty. Get up on your knees, because you know you better. I've been getting money, but she's just a tease.
Let me tell you, we're about to hit the me and you know this is cool. And I'm rolling with the XL Pitbull.
XL Pitbull. You know how we do.
1-800-888-97.2.
All right, let's go. This way.
Yeah.
What's going on?
Look here, man. We in the Conrad.
It's a little bit far from the strip, but it's okay. But we about to go to Zook. Zook nightclub. We a little late, and they might take our table away, but it's okay.
How you feeling, Johnny?
$1 million, baby.
You
look good, you feel good. You hear me? If you haven't been to Vegas, I'm trying to tell you, you look good, you feel good, baby.
I'd be acting differently.
Bro! Don't do that.
Don't do that. We didn't go outside.
Oh, now this. That's where we came from. We dadded you?
That's a Corvette.
Yeah, I see it earlier.
Action! Brother.
That was awesome.
Don't ever stay behind me when I'm doing that.
That was awesome. That was awesome, by the way.
Really?
Yeah, you did great. Hey, the comments going to get at you.
You got it. Play that shit back. I want to see.
Big time, bro.
Thank you, guys.
Hell yeah, yeah. Listen, all right.
Thank you, brother.
Enjoy the rest of your
stay. You too. That's crazy, bro. I'm chilling in the lobby. It's 5 a.m.
And the cameras called you out.
The cameras. That's why I was dancing for the cameras. They said, hey, everybody from up top says Big Boy Johnny. I was like, who am I? That made my night, man. I appreciate y'all, man. Whoever y'all up there. Stay up there. I love y'all.
All right, guys. Our Vegas trip is coming to an end.
Oh, my God.
We're about to head home right now. Long night. As we're filming this right now, I don't know what you guys saw. I don't know what footage we're going to keep, but yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed the vlog. Got some Shake Shack right here, man, and until next time. Peace.
All right, guys, so just got back from the mailbox store. I've been out of town for a little while, so I had some packages that have been sitting there for a while now, so I figured, you know, unbox them with you guys real quick. Kind of forgot what we ended up getting, actually. All right, so this one is... Oh! So basically, one of my favorite sneakers are the PJ Tucker Kobe 5s. I still actually don't even have those in my collection in my size. If anybody has an 8.5, holla at me. But these kind of reminded me of those. We got the Air Force 1 Year of the Dragons. I got these for 146 from Exhibition. 146. All right. Woo! Alright, these so far look a little bit better than I was expecting. We got kind of like a snakeskin vibe right here on the swoosh. We got a metallic jewel swoosh right here. I'm not really sure what this little jewel is, but I might have to take that out. But yeah, overall, really cool. Nice for the summer. Can't beat 140. Alright. Oh my goodness gracious. I know what this is. So when Fear of God was campaigning all of the Adidas Fear of God athletic clothing, there was this one pair of sneakers. I was like, what are those? When are those coming out? Are those officially gonna be from Adidas? But it actually ended up being a release from Fear of God's 8th collection. So I had to check them out, man. Kind of gave me like a Visvim original Yeezy 750 vibe. So I had to check these out. And man, they were not cheap, but you know, always gotta support Fear of God and what they're doing. And I like, shout out to Paul, man. He did a video and he had a line about Fear of God just not being relatable anymore. And man, I kind of feel what he's saying. But I had to check him out. All right. Traditional Fear of God box. Ended up getting a size 40 in these right here. Let's see, I'm excited to see these, man. All right. Woo! So we got, okay, you know, in hand they're not as the shape is kind of throwing me off. All right. And then I didn't think actually this back portion would be as shiny as it was. I'm seeing these in real time with you guys right now. I'm not Ooh. All right, so the reason I didn't get the tan pair that they were originally teasing is this actually toe box part had a bunch of like little beads, basically like metallic beads, and it looked a little off. I was like, would I see myself rocking a mock like sneaker with a bunch of little beads right there? I couldn't really see myself rocking those. But yeah, so I got the all black pair. I don't even think I have to put these on foot to even know that I'm gonna actually return these. And something about this like silhouette that he always uses for his bottom platform, I just don't really like how much this protrudes in the toe box area. Man, these had a lot of potential. I'm a little disappointed in these. I'm not gonna lie, man. I'm actually really disappointed in these. All right, paid about $1,500 for these, and I'm gonna have to go and say, these are a drop. All right. Last shoe. I have no idea what this is, actually. Like I said, I've been out of town. We got a pair of Air Force Ones. What do we got? Oh! So, actually, one of my favorite aesthetics back in the day, you know how everybody was doing, like, the DIY customs, you know, dyeing their sneakers and everything? And one of my favorite types were when people actually dip them in coffee. I think we might have tried once, and it just turned out horrible for a pair of Air Force Ones. But it looked like Nike took some notes from people and basically made a coffee-dipped Air Force One. And I saw these, man. I was like, hey, pretty much they did the work for you. And it actually has a little bit more of a premium-esque vibe to the structure. Like, you can even see right here, it is leather lining, leather insole. I got these for... Oh, these were, like, I could not find these anywhere. The only place I was able to find them was Flight Club. I'm not sure if they were the only ones that got, like, a stock list or whatever. But, yeah, these were pretty much $115. A little bit over retail, can't beat that. This is something that I used to really like when people did to the Air Force Ones. And they pretty much got the job done for you. But, yeah, these are clean. $115. Couple... Nice little solid Air Force One pickup right here. $115 and $146 right there. Can't beat that. The fear of gods. Them things going back. Those are trash. But yeah, let me know which Air Force One you guys liked out of these two. I'll leave links down below so you guys can purchase them yourselves if you're looking into them. I wanted an 8.5 in these, but I ended up getting an 8, and they look way too small, actually. 8.5 was good in these Air Force Ones, it seems like. And what else? Oh, if you guys get a chance to, please hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and leave a comment down below. Always really helps us out. You know, always been reading the comments lately, and really appreciate you guys, man. And that's pretty much it. I'll check you guys next time. Peace!